Hi Capricorn, it's Sloane Rhodes here with your love and romance reading for the months of August, September, and October. And looking at a three-month time frame for you here, Capricorn. This is for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Let's go ahead and get started, Capricorn. Today I'm going to be drawing one card from the Enchanted Map Oracle deck by Colette Baron-Reed. Three cards from the Mary L. Tarot in the position of past, present, future. And then one card from the Earth Magic deck by Stephen Farmer. So, Capricorn. I am reminding all signs that the life purpose and career readings will be released here on the YouTube channel for August, September, and October in about a week. And if you are interested in the monthly life purpose, career, and money readings, those are available at the Sloane Academy. There's a link here as well as below. There's a free 30-day trial, so you can check it out. After that, it's 99 cents a month. And what else do I want to say? I think that's it. Let's get started. So the next love reading, Capricorn, will be in September, and that will be a more directed reading in which I will look at the overarching theme for September, and then I'll do another one in October, and then what you're meant to do, not doing what you can look forward to regardless. So, but this is just an overarching kind of general reading for you. Okay, home. Look at that. Home is where the heart is. Well, Capricorn, you are an earth sign. Your belongings in your home in the earthly realm is very important to you. It helps to give you a sense of security, comfort, and there is a focus on the home here. Let's see what else I can get. But I think that in a lot of ways, as I kind of feel it for you, it's like a you grounded yourself here in the home card, but you're opening the door. It's like there's like an awakening, an opening that's occurring at your third eye, even at your crown chakra, where you are seeing things not so grounded in the material world, but you're opening the door more and more to your spiritual gifts. You do this already in lots of beautiful ways, but during this particular time frame, I think that you're wanting more of that spiritual connection in terms of your love partnerships and your loving relationships in general. You cannot deny the awakening that's occurring, and you're trusting your intuition, and you're listening to spirit more and more, and you're going within, and I feel like in the darker moments, in the nighttime, there's a peace and a deepening of what has been occurring in your life up to now that is occurring. So a lot just came in. Let's see what else comes up. And don't worry about the time. Things take the time they take. You're exactly where you're meant to be. You cannot miss out on anything that is truly meant for you, Capricorn. Don't worry. I feel like some Capricorns are like, time's running out. It's not. I promise it's not. There may even be a desire for some of you to attend church or what you consider to be a church for you. Some people, that's nature. But for some of you, I feel like there may even be this desire to, I don't know why it's coming in like that, but it is, to go to church. I don't know. It's weird. The way I'm feeling it is... Okay, so in the recent past, we have the Knight of Swords. In the present moment, we have the Five of Swords in reverse, which is really, really nice to see for you, Capricorn. And in the future, we have the Seven of Cups. We have that Three of Swords in reverse under the deck. Again, it's like there's this awakening that's occurring. And with the Three of Swords under the deck in reverse, it's like you've been trying to suppress this heartache that may have been occurring for you around love. Maybe you've been burying yourself in work. Maybe you've just been trying to overly intellectualize it. and that if you can overcome this, then all will be well. You can't approach it from that that standpoint. You can't approach the pain of the heart from the head. You know, you have to experience the heartache. And this is what the suffering, this is what helps to expand your experience and create a more spiritual connection and understanding of how, of your experience as a human, of course, but in particular for you, since this is a love reading, how you experience love. It's not just about the physicality of love or it making sense. You can't outthink this one. You gotta feel it, you know. That's what brings you home. That's what connects you to who you truly are. Again, there's this awakening, this third eye opening, the crown chakra, allowing more connection there. Trusting your intuition. Listening to the voice of spirit in the deep dark dead of night. Now, for some of you, there may have been an air sign in the recent past. It would be a Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius individual. There's a lot of determination here with this individual, around you and this individual. It was too aggressive. It was too much. Even though it's in the upright, it's still, I feel like in the recent past, it was just a lot. And you were blinded, or they were blinded. Somebody wasn't seeing the situation clearly. There's like a trigger response, and then they just like, off they went, or off you went, or something like that, I don't know. And I'm really drawn to these owls. I don't know if you can see it, but there's a tiny little owl right here that's speaking to me very loudly. And then here, we have this owl just looking right at us, but seemingly blind. I think what's occurred here in the recent past is we have the divine masculine energy was too focused in on a particular outcome or agenda, or there was a lot of attachment or something like that. There's a lot of goal. I'm just really drawn to the divine masculine, which isn't negative. It's just an energy where there is a lot of energy directed at something or someone in order to achieve a desired outcome or goal. And it was too much. You know, you have to play in the more divine feminine energies here of trusting your intuition, trusting your third eye. Opening to the voice of spirit, allowing things to be without them needing to be a certain way. This is what increases the suffering, the attachment to a certain outcome or agenda or an individual. Doesn't mean it's easy. You can just like think it and then be like, okay, I'm not attached anymore. Unfortunately, it doesn't really work like that. There has to be some opening and awareness of the suffering that you're experiencing. And here it's being suppressed. You know, it happens. But there's an opportunity here to open to it. Now, what I love to see in the present moment here, Capricorn, we have this Five of Swords in reverse. So the ego, you know, here in the recent past, you know, much more like, I'm going to make it happen. And then here we have like this, the egoic need to be right or to speak your piece or to convince the other person or they for you. Those swords are being laid down, and there's an opening, and people are more, again, open to say, hey, what exactly is going on? There's not so much a need to be right or someone to be victorious. It's a really lovely card in the reverse here for you, especially around this idea of home. There may have been something going on in the home, too, where there's more open communication, and people are less sniping and less trying to get on top of the other person and be the winner kind of thing in the present moment here. So it's a nice energy for you. Now, as we go into September and October, we have the Seven of Cups. I love this card. It's so intense. Now with the Seven of Cups, sometimes it's really hard to see things clearly. And you may feel confused. You have to go within. You can't outthink this one. You have to feel. You've got to feel it to know what you want, to make a decision or a choice. Again, you might feel a lot of confusion, but you know, this wolf isn't feeling confused. And as I feel it, the way the moon is kind of coming out of what could be perceived as his third eye or her third eye, trusting the divine feminine energies, the intuitive processes, the voice of spirit, the little nudge you get, a little tap upon your shoulder, the synchronicities that occur, the repetition of patterns, all of that are your guides and angels and your guidance system trying to get your attention. Take a moment, breathe it in, open to it more and more. Again, the Seven of Cups can feel very confusing. So as we go into the future, just on a practical level, you may have many choices, you know, and it may veer from excitement into, oh, holy beans, what am I going to do? And how can I make this choice? And what is the right decision? Well, do your best, Capricorn, to take the agenda that you are right or wrong off the table and just experience it as it is and which one feels the best. Again, not from your mind, not from what the ego has decided is the right answer, but because you are feeling it. Again, it goes back to that divine feminine energy, the intuitive understandings. That is what will help you make your decision. The confusion comes from trying to outthink it. It's not easy to do. You're going to have to play with it. Everyone does. We all have our processes around this and our time to play with these energies. For you, it looks like it's during this particular time frame. And you have to allow yourself to experience the heartache. Don't throw yourself into work in order to not deal with something. You know, don't throw yourself into partying or anything like that, although that's not really indicated. But, you know, it's the Three of Swords in the reverse. You know, you've got to deal with whatever is causing the heartache. You either have to deal with the heartache or you have to deal with what's causing it in some fashion. At least acknowledge it. The light's doing something weird. Here. We also have this Field of Dreams under the deck. What I'm really, really drawn to are all the women. And it goes back with the Seven of Cups. So that you may be, you know, as we go into October and September, you may have a lot of choices. There may be a lot of people involved. Be easy upon yourself here, Capricorn. I love that there's this Five of Swords here. There's an opening here. Less ego. Really, really nice. You're listening more. You're hearing more. You're opening more, which is really, really beautiful. Whatever's going on for you in love, it may have to do with an air sign. It doesn't have to be, but an energy like that. Or someone who has a lot of air in their chart. You're opening more now. You're available to hear what they're saying or they're available to hear what you're saying more. But the suffering is what does help with the opening of the heart. With that suffering, the attachments, the agendas, the expectations, the need, all of that creates suffering. And through the suffering of not getting what we think we want, that our mind thinks it wants, what the ego thinks it wants, through the suffering or what feels like the withholding even sometimes, that's how we deepen our connection to the divine, to spirit. And I see that, I mean, I felt that right away with you. You know, with this third eye, seeing more clearly, perceiving into the unseen more, Capricorn. Wow, very intense reading for you. Be gentle upon yourself. You know, get some rose quartz, put it on your chest, slip it under your pillow at night. You can even put a hot water bottle if it's not 1,000 degrees at your house. put a hot water bottle on your chest, you know, not too hot, but just, you know, to comfort yourself during this time frame. Get some Reiki. Not just because I'm a Reiki practitioner, but from somebody in your area, you know. I mean, I do long-distance Reiki, but go to an energy healer. This kind of thing would be really beneficial for you. Purification, rain. Yeah, I mean, let the emotions come. It's too bound up here. Again, sometimes you don't realize that you're holding on or that you're protecting yourself or you don't want to deal. That's okay. You know, there's no right or wrong way, Capricorn. There's no judgment here. It's just that this is how the reading's coming through for you. And it would be extremely beneficial for you to allow yourself to be purified through the expression of your suffering and your emotion. The realness of that, when you feel like your heart is breaking open because you're crying so hard, it doesn't feel good necessarily in the moment, but it's through that awareness that you touch spirit more and more. So something to think about. Anyway, a very intense reading. Be so kind and gentle to yourself, Capricorn. Check back in September and see what's going on there. Again, this is for Capricorn Sun, Moon, and Rising. You can, for some people, their Venus sign is something that they always check, so this, again, would apply to Capricorn Venus, but watch your Rising and Moon signs as well. I wish you much love, Capricorn. And I'll see you either at the Sloane Academy or here on the YouTube channel or for your own private Reiki or Tarot appointment. Much love.